Now it is important you go there to seek for advice, because why? You are paying for it.
And you deserve it. You deserve it.
I laugh in spiritual balance.
Don't be a victim by being foolish.
Hello, everybody.
Hello.
Welcome to our YouTube channel. We are the Common Sense
Sisters.
My name is Yo-Yo and her name is...
My name is Ella.
First of all, we want to thank all our esteemed subscribers. We thank you for all you do. We thank you for liking, sharing, and leaving your comments, subscribing.
Yes.
And then we welcome all our new subscribers. We'll say, come.
Come and join the winning team.
Yay.
Subscribe.
Yes.
Click the notification bell.
Yes.
Ring, 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 ring.
Yes. And for all those who are still in doubt
or on the fence, please jump over. Come and take your position in your front row seat or on your bed, wherever you're watching from.
Yeah. So let's get to it. Today we have an interesting topic to dish out. And Ella will be the one taking lead on this topic.
Anchoring.
Dishing out some wisdom here and common sense. So what are we talking about today, Ella?
Today we are talking about how to select the right courses in university. Now,
in Canada.
Now, hear me, students, hear me. Especially international students, hear me.
It will help you.
The first thing to do when you land the country or when you arrive on campus is to walk or run straight to your academic advisor's office. These are the people that will tell you what courses you're supposed to take, what you're not supposed to take, how many credits you need. They will give you all the information you need to know about your academics throughout the university. Now, it is important you go there to seek for advice, because why? You are paying for it.
And you deserve it.
You deserve it.
Ask all the questions.
Mm-hmm.
Go with a journal. Write it
Write
down.
Everything down. I advise you go at least twice in the school year, beginning of the first semester, beginning of the second semester. That's what I did. I did it for the last, 3 years of my undergraduate, because I didn't know anything about it in first
with
year.
With the handwriting of the course advice.
Yes. When I went to the academic advisor in my second year, and I went back in my final year, she saw that I had the same paper she had given me what?
And she
said, 3 years ago. And she said, I wish other students were like you. I wish they listened. I still have the paper up until today.
You do.
Now, in my first year, it took my sister and I 7 good hours.
Across the ocean.
Across the Atlantic.
She was in Nigeria.
Yeah.
I was in the US.
Mm-hmm.
We were sourcing for courses.
Yeah, because I didn't know what to take. I didn't, York University, they will not tell you anything, no. They just throw you into the ocean.
Exactly.
Into the ocean. And that's what it's life too.
Plus, we didn't want our father's hard-earned money and our mother's hard-earned money.
Coins to waste.
To go to waste.
What's when you're already paying for the counselors?
Mm-hmm.
So number one, academic advising.
Mm-hmm.
Number two, you must know the difference between your required and elective courses.
Very essential.
Some required courses have prerequisites. Prerequisites are courses that you have to take before you take another step. So you might have to take this first year course before you move on to the second year.
Mm-hmm.
And you need those courses to graduate. They are required. Now, electives could be maybe you want to be a doctor, you're going through kinesiology, all your kinesiology courses are required, but you need an elective from maybe social science class, and then you take an elective, you can take anything from there. Don't want to be taking
dance courses
that don't wager. They don't have any strength because you take it easy to pass. Those elective courses they are taking, will they allow you graduate?
Ask yourself.
Do they have sufficient credits for you to be able to graduate? That brings me to number three. You must ensure that the courses you're taking, they're accredited and they're essential, meaning that you have to be able to use them to graduate. Not the one that when you decide for you to graduate, they will say, actually,
You have been yoked.
Actually, you have not met the eligible requirements that makes you eligible to be able to graduate.
And you have to stay another year.
Another year, another semester. You're not a mumu. Don't fall for that kind of trap. Next on the list, recommendation from somebody who has already taken the course before. If you know somebody who is in the same program or taking some elective courses, they can recommend those courses to you. And then you do your own research to ensure that what you're taking is required, and then you also can take those courses and you'll get, you know, an A+ or A or whatever during the course. Now, the next thing on the list is Rate My Professor. There are websites like ratemyprofessor.com where you can go to search for good professors, see what people are rating. don't go there and take everybody's word for it, because obviously there are some horrible students who rate good professors horribly and vice versa. But take your bits and points, do your research. It's nice when you know somebody from the class. Give it a try, you know? Don't go and take on a professor where 90% of the people complained, and then you go in thinking that you can change the class. You are the one that's going to carry the first A+. No, you have to be what? Wise.
Again, apply common
sense. Next on the list, once you have done all these other things I've mentioned, you have to ensure that you are setting an alarm months before the time of the day where the course lines are open. Me, I used to set my own in January. When time to select courses in June for the next semester
in advance.
How
proactive
you have to be very, very, very detailed. So that when it's time for you to select the courses on that 12 a.m. when that time hits, you are going there registering, because it can get full and you don't want to hear, actually, we only have one professor for this class. And the next time it's going to be available is next year. I laugh with spiritual powers. I laugh with patience.
Don't be a victim by being foolish.
Now, this is all I have. This is all the wisdom I have to dish. If you've done anything differently and it has worked for you, please share with us in the comment section.
Exactly.
If you've heard anything new that you know you've not heard before, please share with us in the comment section. If anything I've missed or you've learned, share in the comment section.
Okay. For the sake of quick summary, let's ask
them out. Okay.
Can you just quickly summarize or list the points out there? Yes. Number one,
academic advising.
Two,
required or elective courses.
Three,
recommendation from somebody who has gone through the course.
Four,
does it have sufficient credits enough for you to graduate?
Five,
rate my professor. And number six, select the courses on the day when the course lines are
open. We hope that with these few points of ours, that you have received common sense to set you up for your university life. For those of you who are already in university, to inspire you
to apply this method.
To apply this method. It has worked. And it works.
I didn't get yoked. Yoke did not catch me.
So please leave your questions in the comment section. We would read them, do our best to, you know, respond to them as well and answer them.
Continue to like, share,
and subscribe. Please share this video.
Subscribe.
Please, you will be helping someone who is an international student or even a student in general. You know, to have awareness or have some ideas, and it can help them. So we encourage you to share this on all social media platforms. If you haven't subscribed to our channel, kindly consider subscribing. Watch all our videos.
We dish them out 3 times in a week. This content.
Premium
content. Common sense.
With love.
To share for students should watch it. Parents should watch it. All age groups. Gather and watch it, because you're going to learn from it.
Yes. All right.
And with that, we say, make common sense. Never depart from you. Bye.